I would like to thank you for all for joining us today. I would like to thank No Border Academy for arranging such a great event to raise awareness about human rights violation in Balochistan. Ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan has been committing human rights violation in Balochistan since 1948, when it occupied Balochistan forcefully. To ensure its continued occupation of Balochistan, Pakistan's military has started a dirty war. The crimes against humanity and war crimes that Pakistani military has been committing in Balochistan include indiscriminate bombardment, uncivilian population, arbitrary arrests, attacks on peaceful protests, extrajudicially killing of Baloch political prisoners, target killing of mostly learned and educated members of Baloch society, and abduction of thousands of Baloch activists. Today I'm going to give a presentation about Balochistan brief history and human rights violation and geopolitical importance. This is the map of Greater Balochistan. This is the structure of my presentation where I'm going to give brief history of Balochistan, geostrategic importance, natural resources, poverty in Balochistan, strategic importance of Gwadar Fort, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, intense military oppression and human rights violation, peaceful protest of Baloch political parties and human rights organization. Balochistan is located in the eastern part of Middle East, linking Central Asia states, Central Asian states within the Indian subcontinent, the Persian Gulf, and the Indian Ocean. The Baloch landscape covers approximately 683,000 square kilometers, as big as France, which is stretching in Pakistan, Iran, and Afghanistan. Balochistan has almost 1,000 kilometer coast import, geo-important coastline. You can see this is all very important coastline of Balochistan. About the population of Balochistan, there are 33 million ethnic Baloch people live in the world, about which 14 million people live in Balochistan, which is occupied in Pakistan, Iran, and Afghanistan. Balochistan has always been an attraction, the imperialist and capitalist power, because of her geopolitical importance. Baloch always defeated the outsiders. The British occupied the vast and thickly populated India. It did not succeed to subjugate the Baloch. The Baloch fought many violent wars against the British colonial in Balochistan. There were treaties and lease agreement between the two sovereign states, but neither state invaded the other. But the British applied the policy of divide and rule. They divided Balochistan in three parts. One part they gave to Iran, one part, small part in Afghanistan, and one part they occupied themselves. After the Second World War, when the British want to leave the subcontinent, they designed to create a newly Pakistan, and also announce the independence of Balochistan. On the 4th August 1947, a tri-parate agreement was signed between Pakistan, the British, and Balochistan, called the Stand Still Agreement, in which the sovereign status of Balochistan was accepted. The Khan, the ruler of Balochistan, the Khan of Qalat declared the Balochistan independent on 12th August 1947. 2 days before the independence of Pakistan, soon after the independence, elections were held. Balochistan's bicameral legislation and a period of tranquility and peace was ensured in the country. The New York Times reported on August 12, 1947, the independence of Balochistan, and printed a map of the world showing that Balochistan is a fully independent country. But unfortunately, after 8 months, and 27th March 1948, Pakistan occupied Balochistan forcefully. Since then, Baloch has never accepted the fake political boundaries dividing its territory, nor has accepted the illegal occupation of these oppressed states. Since the occupation of its territory, Baloch has been struggling against this occupation. And for the liberation of its motherland, Pakistan military has carried out a number of ruthless military operations to suppress the Baloch aspirations of liberty, peace, and justice by killing thousands of innocent Baloch and displacing hundreds of thousands. Now we're going to talk about the geostrategic importance of Balochistan. With its strategically important Balochistan bridges the Middle East and South Asia to Central Asia and South Asia, and form the closest ocean frontage for the landlocked country of Central Asia. You're looking there, it's in Afghanistan, there's after Central Asia, there's landlocked. It will connect by Balochistan with Gwadar forts. It will connect Iran to Iraq, Turkey. It also will connect Saudi Arabia, Oman to Africa, and Far East. Mineral resources of Balochistan. Balochistan is rich in oil and gas. With its soil that hold large quantity of gold, coal, copper, silver, platinum, aluminum, uranium, etc. Estimated reserves, 80 trillion cubic feet gas, 7.5 trillion of barrels of oil can be explored. Balochistan fulfilling 80% gas requirement of Pakistan, with $39 billion per year. And also, Balochistan possesses more than 45 metallic and non-metallic minerals. There's also two gold mines, what is called Sandek Project. One is called Sandek Projects, which provides 16,000 tons of copper, 52,000 ounces of gold, 104,000 ounces of silver for years. And there's other gold mine, it's called Reko Diq which is in district Chagi in Balochistan. It's the world's largest gold and copper mine. It produced 200 tons of copper and 400,000 of ounces of gold per year. Expected revenue from all these mineral resources will exceed of $1.6 billion per year. This is the richest Belarusian data. I'm showing the image of richest Belarusian in minerals. But now I'm going to show the other aspects of Balochistan. The poverty in Balochistan. Even since its forceful annexation in 1948, Balochistan has been subjected to military colonization, political marginalization, economic exploitation, and cultural hegemony. Balochistan resources have been plundered by the state of Pakistan and accelerating speed. Baloch are living in extreme poverty and hardship. Baloch are kept away systematically from effective education, health, and basic necessity. They have been prevented from practicing and developing their culture. A prevalent Pakistani curriculum has been imposed on Baloch. This is the mineral resource, rich resource of Balochistan. The image you're seeing. According to the Asian Human Rights Commission, 80% population is living under poverty. 78% of the population has no access to electricity. That's using Stone Age. That's very dark, nothing to see. 78% of the population has no access to electricity, and 79% has no access to natural gases, while 91% of the population in rural areas rely on contaminated rainwater. If there's rains, they will get easily water. Otherwise, they will face much problem to getting water. That is showing this picture. What kind of water they were using. The strategic importance of Gwadar Fort. This is Gwadar. The city of coast line areas, it's very important. China and Pakistan announced Gwadar is located at the junction of South Asia, Central Asia, and Middle East. It is close to Iranian border, and Gwadar Fort is set just 200 miles from Strait of Hormuz, one of the most important oil supply route in the world, where 60% of China country's oil is pumping through Strait of Hormuz. Pakistan has leased the Gwadar Fort of Balochistan to China for 40 years to develop and operate. It will be under full administration control of China. Gwadar is expected to have the capability of handling up to 19 million tons of crude oil per year, which will be refined at the port itself and then sent to China through the Gwadar southwest region of China. It's called Kashgar. Its present Chinese oil supplies are passing through Strait of Malacca. In Indian Ocean, which are fully at the mercy of USA Navy deployed there to safeguard Southeast Asian nation from Chinese aggression. Chinese fear of her USA naval blockade. By this way, if China supplied oil from Strait of Hormuz to China, it's take 14,500. But if they operate Gwadar, from Gwadar to China, Kashgar, it will take 2,500. It is the route where China using here, come here, Strait of Malacca, then come, reach there in China regions. China-Pakistan economic corridor. China and Pakistan announced $46 billion investment program to build a transportation corridor from port of Gwadar, Balochistan to Xinjiang region in northwestern China. China aims to connect Gwadar to Kashgar with a nearly 3,000 kilometer long network of motorway and rail roads and oil and gas pipeline as well. Constructing necessary power plants, industrial units, and other infrastructure along the way through Pakistan. In time, the route will link with Chinese railway, bringing Afghanistan's wealth to world markets. Some analysis argue that port could become China's naval base in the Indian Ocean and enable Beijing to monitor Indian and USA naval activities. Also been called the westernmost link in China's string peril strategy. The most India is worried about the circling of China, where China making forts, the some ports in Sri Lanka, maybe in Bangladesh, the covering the Indian Oceans. India fears that it's threat for Indians. If China operate Gwadar, they will set their naval base in marine power in Gwadar areas, the naval base. They will control these regions. Then China will control all the business to the Central Asia, to South Asia, to Middle East, and Europe, and African countries. And the other side, the most dangerous side of implementation of China-Pakistan economic corridor is increasing in military operation by Pakistan to crush the Baloch resistance and to prove the way for China-Pakistan economic corridor. The killings, enforced disappearances and judicial torture are on rise to speed up the projects. Because one of the most big problem of China is, to operate Gwadar and make an economic corridor, the Baloch insurgency. Because the Baloch is fighting for freedoms. The Baloch saying, we will not allow to exploit our resources or minerals until we are not free. Because the Baloch is fighting for freedom since 1948. To operate, to make success this project, they intensified their military operation in Balochistan to crush the Baloch people. Since the beginning of January 2015, the Pakistani army, along with its intelligence agencies, has launched an unending series of house-to-house search operation in Dera Bhagutti, Awaran, and Makuran areas of Balochistan. In the name of search operations, the Pakistani forces have committed war crimes such as killing innocent, non-combatant, abducting civilians, and raising entire villages. This has resulted in forced migration of hundreds of thousands of Baloch civilians in these areas. An estimated 75,000 Baloch have been internally displaced in Awaran and near villages alone. Forcibly evacuation of people by the Pakistani army and its agencies in different regions in Makran, Balochistan have displaced another 550,000 people. It's quite possible that the figures related to IDPs are much higher than the estimated ones. In August this year, on the holy day, Eid, Pakistani regular army launched a massive offensive in Awaran district and bombed three entire villages of using gun-shaped helicopters and jet fighter and cordoned up the area for a whole month. All male members who survived the attack were abducted. Now their bodies were being dumped one by one on a daily basis. The district Awaran, it's my hometown where I lived. Also during this month, military operation, which the cordons, my mother also died, the same situations. I was here in Germany. Today, not a single day passes without armed forces conducting search operation, an important tool for them to raid houses, raise villages, burn property in fertile land, loot precious metal and jewelries, harass children and women, abduct, torture and kill people during such search operation. These search operations are always preceded by the aerial bombardment and siege of entire areas. Baloch homes, made of wood and flammable materials, which is easily burnt and eliminated the evidence. The people of Baloch who is living like these homes in isolated areas, the Pakistani army is burning the houses. Like this is the house which is burning. All houses are totally destroyed after some minutes of fire. Like this. Village destroyed by Pakistan army, but without evidence. That's the genocide strategy of killing Baloch systematically. They destroyed three villages, but it seemed nothing. Like the wind and the rains will easily eliminate the evidence, the source. By this strategy, the genociding, the Baloch people, the killings, but word is silence. Enforced disappearances. According to the Voice of our Baloch Missing Person, this organization, 20,000 Baloch are missing in the last decades. 2,000 political activists' decomposed bodies have been found in isolated places. Baloch have gone missing, political activists. Those are political actors, doctors, lawyers, teachers, journalists, farmers, shopkeepers, as well as women and children. Ladies and gentlemen, last month, the Home Secretary of Balochistan, Akbar Hussain Durrani, confirmed that the security forces have arrested more than 8,000 person and killed more than 200 in just last 10 months. This is a statement of Baloch National Movement who was given in seminars. I quoted this one. He also revealed that this all has been done under the National Action Plan. National Action Plan, the there's a rule, law, it's passed in from parliament that the army can kidnap, torture and kill. It was not answerable. By this national action plan, what I said, he went on further saying that 1,840 intelligence-based operations have been conducted in Balochistan, in his own words. After the implementation of National Action Plan in December last year, he called it a great success. Now the question that hunts everybody is that where are those 8,000 people that the mighty Pakistani security establishment claim to have arrested, and why they are not being prosecuted according to the law? Why their families have no clue about their whereabouts? Mass graves. On January 2014, three mass graves were found in Tutak Khuzdar. It's a district, Balochistan district, Khuzdar. More than 100 decomposed bodies were found, according to the Asian Human Rights Commission. But the locals say 169 decomposed bodies were found, according to the locals. Because the Pakistani military forces cover this area, they were not allowing the people to go, the media, to reveal and unearth the mass graves. Presence of Islamic terrorist groups in Balochistan. Tied up Islamic fundamentalism in Balochistan. Pakistan is trying to promote Islamic radical element to counter Baloch national freedom movement. Pakistan has unleashed its proxy group like the Lashkar-e-Jangvi, Jamaat al-Dawa, who are building madrasas throughout Balochistan and preaching hatred. They are targeting women and girls' education and minorities. The Tanzim al-Islam al-Furqan, threatened the schools, which are English medium, are co-education in Panjgur, Balochistan, which was closed by this religious terrorist organization. A teacher, Zahid Askani, was killed in Gwadar, Balochistan. Daesh or ISIS claimed the responsibility, according to locals. These fanatic elements have caused the Baloch women to stay away from political gathering and protest. Otherwise, they will face grave consequences. Because the Baloch women are at the forefront of the current liberation struggle of Balochistan, peaceful political activism and awareness campaigns. You know, the Baloch student organization, it's now first time its chairperson is a girls, the woman in history, in Balochistan, Baloch history. It's now become the chairperson of Baloch student organization. In Awaran, Zikri community worship places was attacked. Six were found dead and seven were wounded. It's also our hometown area. Where some terrorists came and attacked and killed these peoples. There was threatening message inscribed on the walls, Zikri and Hindus. Conversion to Sunni Islam are face death. long live Dash, long live ISIS, which is in while talking, they're showing it's translated in English. Neither Hindu, neither Zikri, only Sunni. Step forward, Khalifa Abu Bakr Baghdadi, we are with you, Lashkar Khorasan. Who is working there and killing the people, the activists, the minorities. The message sent by Lashkar Khorasan, Balochistan's secular and enlightened characters have always been challenged for Pakistani's Islamic ideologies. The terrorist groups have their camp in different corners of Balochistan. These camps are under the supervision of intelligence agencies that are all connected to military effort to radicalize Balochistan. Ladies and gentlemen, there was an earthquake in Balochistan on 24 September 2013. An earthquake with a magnitude of 7 occurred. Awaran Balochistan, which resulted in more than 1,000 casualties and 350,000 people homeless. Pakistani authorities refused to allow the international aids, including UNO relief workers, to help the peoples. Using the disaster relief is a strategic advantage. The army has been expanding its military power to target Baloch nationalists. The army has sent up numerous new checkpoints. Pakistan only allowed the Islamic extremist NGOs like Jamaat al-Dawah and Al-Khidmat Foundation to help, but even in hard time, the Baloch people principally refused to get aid from these jihadis. And in this duration, they also raided my houses in District Awara. That time I was not there, they kidnapped my cousin, Safar Ali. It's until now his custody. But we don't know he's alive or died, maybe thrown in mass graves. Atomic test in Balochistan. Pakistan conducted 5 nuclear explosion tests in Balochistan land. The whole region of Chagi got destroyed, and soon after the nuclear explosion, the radioactivity, leukemia, cancer, and numerous genital diseases have been reported from the surrounding regions. The radiation of nuclear test still exists in the area and horribly impacting the ecology. The newborn babies as well as their mother are also suffering from adverse affected. The historical peaceful protest against gross human rights violations. Voice for Baloch missing persons have recorded a long march in history of South Asia. Voice for Baloch missing persons, the families who make organization to protesting to safe release of their dear ones. They start a long march 2013 route from Quetta to Karachi and Karachi to Islamabad. This took 4 months and walked distance 2,300 kilometers. This long march was led by 75 years old man and a 10 years boy Ali Haider and a girls 23 years old. During this long march, they faced a lot of disturbance and threaten to cut off their long march, but they continue their long march to reach theirs. And the families of missing people take part on hunger strike, which is continued for 7 years. The date is counting 2,304 days until today. It still is going on, this talk on hunger strikes, calling the world to help this, to save, release their dear ones. There's other hunger strike. This is the boy Latif Johor, who is the member of a student organization. He began hunger strikes for the safe release of his chairman, Zahid Baloch, who was abducted in Quetta in 2014. They announced to sit hunger strike till death. He ended his protest after 46 days, survived only on water. And after some international organizations, the community convinced them they will try to save, release their chairman, Zahid Baloch. But still, the student leader, Zahid Baloch, is in detention center and missing. Ladies and gentlemen, pre-Balochistan is the need of the hour. If the world forces want to get rid of the religious radicalism, terrorist extremism, jihadi and opportunism of Pakistani establishment, then Baloch can be the most suitable ally to be a strong center for spreading and strengthening of democratic, liberal, and secular norms and values in the adjoining region. The Baloch is fired for a peaceful, just, democratic, nuclear, free, and secular or enlightened Balochistan, a place that will not only play a role in enhancing peace and stability in the wider region, but will become a beacon of development and progress. The Baloch dream of a land where human life is greatly valued, where people are not discriminated against for their race, creed, or color, where people of all faiths can live with equality and harmony, where the rights of minorities and the vulnerable are strongly protected, where people have the right to live and prosper. I hope the world civilized people raise their voices against human rights violation in Balochistan. I hope you all will help us to tell the world ongoing genocide of Baloch Nation in Balochistan by social medias, by Twitter, by Facebook. You can raise your voices against the ongoing genocide and killing the people. I hope you will support us. Because I came here for this reason, let the world to know what is going on in Balochistan. Yeah, my life is in danger in Balochistan. If I was there, they will find me and torture and kill and throw in isolated area. But I came here only let to know the world, what's going on. Because Balochistan is totally, it's banned. There's no international media. There's no media. What's going on? The world is unknown. I think it's the Balochistan situation is worse than Syria. Every day and every corner of Balochistan is Pakistan military operation is going on. But world is unknown. I know that you will help us to know the world by social medias. Raise your voices. Thank you very much for your attention and joining us. This is our references, which we find it, we collected this. Any questions?